Magic the Gathering is a collectible card game. It's the first of its kind, and has a lot of really ingenious design, and I really love playing it. But it's also has design flaws on a fundamental level. Land, its escalation mechanic, is the most broken amongst these. I will attempt to demonstrate this in three parts. Firstly, why the design is so clever. Secondly, how that limits how good the game can be. And third, why I think Wizards of the Coast should release a completely new version of Magic. Magic the Gathering 2. Magic 2. This time, it's personal. Magic 2. Electric Boogaloo. Magic 2. Now with more blue. Let's take a quick look at the basic mechanics. There are two players. Each has a 60-card deck. There are two types of cards. Spells, which actually do things and try to win the game. And land, which give you mana with which you cast spells. Players take turns, and on each of their turns, they draw one card. The first player skips the draw on their first turn. Spells cost mana, usually between 1 and 5. Cards with a higher mana cost are much more powerful. Each land gives 1 mana each turn. Let's do some quick math then. We have a deck which is 2/5 land and 60% spells. With 7 cards in hand, on the first turn, we expect to have 2.8 lands in hand. On turn 4, we have 4 lands in hand. On turn 7, we have 5 and a bit lands in hand. And we can finally play our incredible 5 mana card. What this means, on turn 1 to 4, we can play a 1 mana, 2 mana, 3 mana, 4 mana card. And then we have to wait till turn 7 to play a 5 mana card, and so on and so on. You get it taking longer to play high mana cost cards. And I think this is absolutely beautiful. It's gorgeous. Without any external tools, using just the card in the deck, we have a progression. As time goes on, cards get more powerful, the stakes get higher, and the player choices change. But what's more, we immediately have two choices of playstyle. We can do stuff faster than our opponent, or we can play slower for bigger rewards, running our opponent out of resources. With some basic card design, we have a beautiful ecosystem in which deck building and playstyle can be changed to beat more of one type or the other. We can have anti-aggressive control decks, or more mid-ranged anti-control decks. Assuming some decent card design, each deck can be countered or has a weakness. So if a strategy comes to dominate, other strategies and decks can be made in order to beat those strategies, and that strategy will no longer dominate. And further to this, in the same way that leveling up in RPGs is fun, both players leveling up is fun. It raises the stakes, it allows more choices, and it tends to the game actually ending. And the game ending is kind of important. We've got stuff to do, monsters to slay, you know, that sort of thing. Oh, and someone needs to win the game. That also matters. And this is genuinely the most genius part of Magic the Gathering. There are obviously some problems. Let's go do that maths again, but a bit better this time. It's turn 3, and we've drawn 9 cards. We should have 3.6 lands in hand. But let's actually do the maths. There are 60 choose 9 possible different hands, and 24 choose 3 different ways to have 3 lands. And there are 36c6 ways to have 6 spells. So we divide 24c3 times 36c6 by 60c9 to get 26.7%. But wait, we can have 5 or 4 lands in swell. So we take 60 choose 4, which is 60 factorial over 4 factorial times 56 factorial. You know what? This is taking too long. I'll just put it all up on screen. Now let's allow a mulligan of all 9 cards for a best of 2. That's more generous than any do-over in any Magic format that I know of. Even with this, the approximate chance of having a good number of lands, between 3 and 5, on turn 3 is 1 in 10. If we have too few lands, we can't play our powerful cards. If we have too much land, we have too few spells to actually do anything. The exact thing that made the design so clever means it doesn't work at least 1/10 of the time. But wait, it gets worse. We have 2 players, so roughly twice the chance, meaning that roughly 1/5 of the time, one player is at a huge disadvantage, and as anyone who played the game will say, this isn't really fun for either player. Furthermore, there are different colours of mana, each with a different type of land. I mean, there are dozens of different types of land, and you could draw all one colour of land and not be able to cast your spells. Furthermore, because there's all these different types of land, you've got to have them in front of you and keep track of them and use up all that table space. Then there's also a minor issue of card advantage becoming land and mana advantage. Imagine it's turn 4. You just played your 4th land. You have no land left in hand. Now you play a card that lets you draw 3 cards. One of these, on average, is a land and 2 are spells. rather than having to wait till turn 7 for your 5 drop, you can play it next turn. We've broken part of the equilibrium that we had earlier. It's not destroyed, it's just less perfect. So here's the thing. Magic Gathering is 30 years old. It's a great game, and it's especially great for short, meaningless games between some orc slaying. But the game's older than me. It needs updating, changing, either because we have better tools now, or because we know the way the game is played better, or because we have learned more about game design. Some of the fundamental design of this beautiful game is beautifully flawed. Land is flawed, the stack is confusing, I think combat needs overhauling. Maybe I'll, ramble about that another time. Wizards of the Coast, please make this wonderful game better. Please make a new Magic. No backwards compatibility, no tweaked formats, no tinkered rules. A new game, new better rules, new better name. Magic the Gathered. Magic the mostly one place, but we still need to get the last few people together. Mundane the Scattering. Mysticism the Assembly. Wizardry, the spread across the landscape.